Hey guys, my name is Jessie Mew, and welcome back to Stardew Valley. In the last episode, we were able to enjoy the Spirit's Eve Festival, which was actually the last festival of the fall season, and now it's the last day of fall. So we have quite a bit ahead of us right now. We have to prepare for the winter time in which we won't be able to grow any crops, I guess. It sounds like all of these crops are going to die off and there's nothing new that we can really plant in the winter time. I'm kind of surprised to see that we still have just a couple things to harvest though. We don't really need to worry about watering these things since tomorrow they're just going to die off anyway, but we might as well collect these. We have little cranberries and we have some corn, which is actually quite good because we can go down to a Pierre's and give him some of that as a gift. Today should be the start of a brand new week, so hopefully, there we go. That's what I like to see. I can give everyone two more gifts this week. It really is funny when they tell me that I can't give them any more gifts. Like, it's a problem that I give these people too many gifts in a week. So now we can go and visit all of these people. We can hopefully gain the hearts of a couple more people down here too. Vincent and Pierre, they really need some work. Maybe we should give Vincent another cake, in fact. We do have a couple more cakes inside the house, I believe. And for that matter, we should check the TV to see if there's any new little recipes that we can learn from the Queen of Sauce. But yeah, we have a chocolate cake for Vincent. We actually got those from the Junimos, and Vincent really seemed to enjoy them. And oh gosh, our golden pumpkin too. It's valuable, but has no other purpose. We actually got this from the Spirit's Eve Festival yesterday because we managed to make it through the hedge maze, the spooky hedge maze, and it gave us that golden pumpkin. Oh my gosh, we actually do have a Queen of Sauce. Okay, good. So let's see what she's going to teach us today. Artichoke dip. This is a delightful way to get more artichokes into your body. Personally, I don't even dip anything in there. I just guzzle the sauce down like it's a milkshake. Delicious. Well, I don't think I'm going to be doing that anytime soon, but there we go. At least we have some new recipes to make, so that's always good. We have quite a few of them, I believe. Not many that we can make at the moment, unfortunately. I'm not sure where the artichoke dip even is. Let's see, pale broth, artichoke dip, there we go. So we actually need milk for that. So it sounds like we're going to need cows before we can actually make that, which is okay. Eventually we will be getting cows anyway. We actually have quite a bit of gold, and I'm hoping that this golden pumpkin is going to be worth even more, so we'll have more gold in the winter time, because it sounds like we're not really going to have many ways to make any sort of money. So hopefully this will be able to last us all through the winter time. And hello, Daisy. It's the last day of fall pretty soon. There is going to be snow on the ground, and I hope Daisy likes snow. Otherwise, she's going to be a little bit uncomfortable. Though she could always go inside. She could always come inside and enjoy the day in the nice warm house next to the fireplace. I'm sure she would enjoy that too, because she does seem to enjoy curling up by the fireplace. And look at that. Our chickens have grown. Oh my goodness. Now I definitely can't tell them apart. Oh my goodness. So let's see. Who are you? You are Quill. So that means that you must be, oh dear, Chirp, I think. Are you Chirp? Yes, you're Chirp. Okay, I'm getting there, guys. And this is Peep, and that means that you are Fluff. Of course, little Fluff. And their hearts are going up quite well, I think. The old chickens that we received a long time ago. And oh my goodness, one of them left us a large egg. Oh my goodness, perfect. They didn't eat their breakfast though, which is a little bit worrying. But I believe we needed to give somebody a large egg. Oh my goodness, where would that be? Would it be in the fodder bundle? No, not there. I could have sworn that like Marnie wanted it or something. Animal bundle? Oh, okay, there we go. So we actually gave them a large white egg before, apparently. But we can give them a large brown egg too, and I think they will be quite happy about that. Then we just need to get some more animals, I guess. Because we'll still need to give them three items out of the selection here. But we don't have them at the moment, so that will not be happening anytime soon, unfortunately. I don't think we're really going to look into purchasing more animals in the wintertime, but I could be wrong. We could at least build the buildings for them, though. I think that would probably be a good idea, as long as we have enough resources and money, of course, because they are quite expensive. And oh my gosh, my little jack-o'-lantern. I forgot to take a look at that when we walked out of the house today. That thing is adorable. We got that from the Spirit's Eve Festival as well, of course. And we can sell off these eggs, maybe. Or should we keep them? You know, it might be a good idea to actually keep those. Then we could give them as gifts around the town, because today seems like it's a pretty good gift-giving day, in my opinion. So we have this frozen tier for Sebastian. We have this piece of corn for Pierre, because he really seemed to enjoy the produce that we gave him before. We're going to try to sell this golden pumpkin to him, too. Like, I'm not really sure if he's going to appreciate it. I'm not sure if he's going to want to buy it from us. But I figured since we basically seem to get the same amount of money from the shipping crate as the shops in the town, we might as well just see, like, exactly what we can get for this golden pumpkin. So that's what we're going to do today. We need to give the dwarf scroll to Gunther, finally, and crack open all of these frozen geodes and regular geodes as well. So hopefully we'll get something good out of those, but we might as well take a look in this chest, just see if there's anything else we can give around the town. Emily loves the quartz, so we'll bring that. I'm sure somebody would enjoy the jade. It looks like we don't have any more of those amethysts, unfortunately, so we can't give that to Abigail if we run into her. We could give Sam a Jojicola, even though they call it trash, because we did test it, and he does enjoy those anyway, even though we fish them out of, like, the smelly old lake and the the awful ocean. He seems to enjoy them. I'm sure he doesn't really know that that's where we're getting them from, but we're not gonna tell him. We're just gonna keep that a secret between all of us. He doesn't need to know where our Jojicolas come from. Okay, so let's see. Let's stop at Pierre's first. Hopefully he's open today. And it looks like we have a quest too, so we might as well pick that up. The monsters known as slime are throwing the elemental balance into disarray. Oh goodness, he wants to slay 4 more of those slimes, which is actually pretty good. The slimes are easy to slay, of course, and there are plenty of them in the mines. So, hello, Pierre. See, it's for sale. Let's see. Oh, he doesn't want our pumpkin. Okay, okay. I wasn't sure if he would actually want to buy that from us or not. So apparently he doesn't like the golden pumpkin. If we can't find anybody who wants this, then we'll just throw it in the bin to sell. That's probably the best way to go about this, but is there anything? I mean, obviously we can't buy the seeds. I know you just said the seeds are for sale, but that would be really silly to buy them on the very last day of fall. So we're not going to do that, Pierre, sorry. But do you have... Whoa, look at that wallpaper. Oh my gosh, that is awesome. Okay, I am buying that. I'm not sure where I'm going to put it, but that is awesome. I really like that too. That's an interesting pattern. The only problem with buying these things is that you can't really go back if you don't like it. Like, it kind of gets rid of whatever else you put down before. So we can't scrape up our old wallpaper and then place it back down again if we wanted to. It's kind of early, so I don't think... Oh gosh, it's not even open! Okay, I was going to say, I don't think Emily's in there yet. And, she is actually not. And we forgot to give Pierre the corn. Oh dear. Well, that's okay. We'll, see him again. We'll definitely see him again. And look at you, Louis, digging around in your little garden. And what on earth is this? A crayfish? Okay, a crayfish. That's interesting. So we have a new little item from there. Let's give our scroll to Gunther, though, to kind of free up our pockets, because we have a lot of stuff in here now. Here you go, Gunther. Let's donate this to the museum. And good, thankfully, we haven't done that yet. So we have 3 different scrolls at the moment, 3 different dwarf scrolls. I wonder if maybe we'll get a special item if we complete the collection. I'm not sure how many dwarf scrolls there actually are, but maybe we'll get something special from them if we manage to collect them all. So let's crack open this geode right here. That's an earth crystal. Well, we know that George likes those, so we might actually run down to George and give him that. What is that? Oh, a fairy stone. Okay, I believe we actually donated that to Gunther before, because I do remember, little bunny, getting the fairy stone before. So I think we're okay with that. We can try to give that to somebody, I guess. I'm not sure who would like it, but we could try to give that to somebody. I mean, somebody would probably enjoy a fairy stone, right? That sounds like something that somebody in this town would enjoy. We could try giving it to Penny. Hello, you. What are you up to? I've been trying to keep our place clean, but it always gets messy again. It's hard to run a household all by yourself. Oh my goodness, we were actually right in the middle of a fight between Penny and Pam over that exact thing. I don't want to offend her by giving her something that she doesn't like, but I am curious if she would like the fairy stone, or maybe Abigail, because it does kind of look like the amethyst. So we might try that. Let's see if she likes the jade, actually. We'll see if Penny is interested in the jade. Oh yeah, she is. Thank you. This looks special. Okay. So she really enjoyed that. Okay. Let's see if Sam is in his house too. Oh, there's Leah. Oh my goodness. I could give you an egg, actually, Leah. You might enjoy that. There. Oh, no, no, no. There you go. This is a really nice gift. Thank you. You are welcome, Leah. She seems to enjoy those. And there's Sam playing the guitar in his room here. No, don't drink that. Jess is just trying to like eat all of the gifts that I want to give to people. Thanks. I really like this. You are welcome. He is having a pretty good time practicing his guitar in there. Jody's not in, so I can't give her an egg. And I know Vincent's not going to want one. Hi there, miss. Hello, Vincent. I think he's warming up to us a little bit. Maybe? Kind of? I'm not sure. It seems like it, though. He might be just a tiny, tiny bit warming up to us. Let's go back up here and give Pierre the corn really quickly before he leaves his shop. I'm not sure when he does. And Abigail, let's see if you like this. Oh no. Oh no, what am I supposed to do with this? I'm sorry, Abigail. I'm sorry. What should I do tonight? I was thinking about dyeing my hair again. What do you think? Dye it black, why not blonde? How about bubblegum pink? And I like your hair just the way it is. I do like your hair just the way it is. I like the color purple, so I do like it just the way it is. But let's see. I don't think she would want to dye it blonde, and probably not black either. That sounds like too natural or normal if she's coming from purple hair. So let's say bubblegum pink. You're always good for a laugh. Okay, so she's not really into that, but she seemed to enjoy it anyway. So let's give her, or Pierre rather, let's give Pierre some of this corn here, and hopefully he likes that? No? Please never bring this to me again? Oh my gosh, I swear, I cannot get on Pierre's good side. I absolutely can't. He really hated that. I thought he enjoyed the produce from our farm. That is terrible. Okay, Pierre, we are on a mission to find something that you actually enjoy. At least Caroline likes us. Oh, that's sweet. Thank you. You are welcome, Caroline. You need to talk to your husband there because he really seems to hate us. Today, I'm just going to relax and think positively. Very good, Caroline. Very good idea. I don't know. What did we give him before? Did we give him a pumpkin? I'm not sure. Like, oh gosh, he really hates us now. He absolutely despises us. If we could have negative arts with people, I think he would literally have that. Oh my goodness. Okay, so let's go up here and give the Junimos the large egg before I forget about that too. And we'll also see if Sebastian is up here so we can give him that frozen tear because we know that he will at least appreciate our gift. He definitely likes the frozen tears. And let's see, what do we need to give this to? I think it was the pantry, right? That would be the animal bundle. Yeah, there we go. Okay, and there we go. So now we just have 3 items left for this bundle, which is not bad. We're moving right along with that one, and hopefully pretty soon we'll be able to complete one of these. I think the closest one is the boiler room, and I don't remember what we actually get from completing all of those bundles, but I believe we only have like 2 more items to give the Junimos to complete that one. So that means what we're going to have to do is explore in the mines a lot more often, but that'll be okay because I have a feeling anyway that once we get into the wintertime, that's pretty much what we're going to be doing because we won't have any crops to deal with, so we'll probably get a little bit further in the mines. He really likes those, so that's nice. At least somebody appreciates our gifts. The sun is coming out less and less these days. Wonderful. Well, you're not going to like it tomorrow, Sebastian, because it's actually going to be winter. You are really not going to like that. I guess what we could do next is go down to George and see if he'll like this earth crystal that we received from our geode. And I'm not sure if there's really any other shops that we could sell the golden pumpkin at anyway. So, well, Jojo Mart, but I'm kind of leery about going there because I feel like I'll probably get ripped off. We actually haven't been to Jojo Mart in ages, so I'm not sure if anything new is there. I mean, we probably should check it out. Oh, a little scene with George. Oh my goodness. Okay, George, I want you to take a deep breath for me. Oh gosh, it's like a doctor appointment with Harvey. Mm-hmm, turn around please. We probably shouldn't be in here actually if he's at his doctor appointment. George, I'll be honest with you. You need to make some changes in your lifestyle if you want to stay healthy. I'd like you to reduce your sodium intake and try to get some moderate exercise with your arms. Oh, he's not happy about that. Oh my goodness. I know what's best for me. Who do you think you are telling me how to live my life? Well, he is your Dr. George. I'm your Dr. George. That's who I am. And I went to school for 8 years so I could learn how to help people stay healthy. And here we are. Like, we should really not be intruding on his appointment here. This is not going to go well. Oh, I'm sorry, but you shouldn't be here. These checkups are supposed to be private. Yeah, probably, huh? Not so fast. I'd like to get a second opinion from this young lady. Oh, dear. Oh, no. We're stuck in the middle again. Very well. Very well. Jess, what do you think George should do? George should follow Dr. Harvey's advice, or George knows what's best for his own body. Well, honestly, I mean, that's his doctor. I'm sure his doctor knows what he should be doing, right? So George should probably follow Dr. Harvey's advice. Thanks, Jess. You see, George, I'm just trying to help you. He's not going to be happy about that, is he? He's not going to be happy with us at all. Fine, I'll do what you say, doctor. Thank you for your help, Jess. I appreciate it. Well, you're welcome. I guess that went a little bit better than I expected. I kind of felt like they were going to be very mad at us. So, actually, let's give this to Alex before he leaves, because we know he likes the eggs. This is cool. Thanks. And then we can give George this earth crystal. Thanks. So both of them were actually pretty happy with that. Wait a second. There we go. Hey, the grid ball game is on today. Sundays are pretty awesome in the fall with that big football there. Grid ball, maybe? Is that what that would be? Aren't you cold? They don't make sweaters like they used to. Oh, George. Always looking out for us, I guess. He's slowly warming up to us, too. He's kind of like Shane, because Shane used to be really, really cranky in the beginning, but he really warmed up to us after all. Need a hot meal? Oh, Gus, you're always so nice. We need to find more gifts for you, too. Let's give this to Emily. Thank you. I'm feeling a positive energy from this gift. Of course, as always. As always. Let's see. What does Gus actually have? We have to go over here. I forgot about that. Let's see. He doesn't want our golden pumpkin either, so we can't give him that. Oh, yeah. He sells a lot of recipes here. I almost forgot about that. We could learn how to make pizza if we wanted to. Then we could actually make, like, fresh pizza for Sam. Oh, my gosh. I forgot we were going to give Sam that pizza. Oh my goodness, it's been so long now. So tomorrow we should definitely do that. On the first day of winter, we're going to go give Sam like a big hot pizza. Oh boy. Oh boy, am I thirsty. Oh my gosh. I did not expect to see Pam walking through right then. Okay. Though she's always at the saloon, so it does make sense. And Harvey, we need to give something to you, but I don't really think you're gonna want our crayfish. And unfortunately, I forgot to bring all of those herbs that we collected and we wanted to give to the doctor. Is he going into his doctor's office? I think he is, though it might be closed. Yeah, it's locked. So if he's going in there, we actually can't see him. You know, no wonder I don't talk to him very often. If he goes in so early, I mean, it's not even 6 o'clock and he is already going into his office and he's locking the doors. So that's probably why I never see him around. And I always forget that we can actually talk to Harvey. We can talk to the doctor in the town and give him gifts too. So that's something that we're going to have to remember. And there's our pickled eggplant, I believe, which doesn't sound very appetizing to me. But that's okay. We'll take that, we'll take the honey, and we'll sell those off, I guess. And we'll just put the golden pumpkin in there, too. We'll see how much we can gather from the golden pumpkin, because I guess the only purpose of this is to sell it off. So hopefully it'll be worth quite a bit. I'd be a little bit disappointed if it wasn't. And the wallpaper. Let's see what the wallpaper looks like, too, while it's still a little bit light out. Oh my gosh, though, I don't really know if I want to get rid of this stuff. Oh my goodness, I love this wallpaper back here, like all these stars. And these adorable little fruits, too, for the bedroom. Oh my goodness, which one am I going to put it in? Let's see, I mean, this is really nice. This is beautiful, you have to admit that. So, oh, the lights just went off. It's like somebody flicked a switch. The lights actually, like, just went off outside. Okay, so let's see. Let's place it. Let's place it in here because this would probably be, it'll really match the painting anyway, right? Oh my gosh, that's so cool. Oh my gosh, I really like that scene. That is really cool. And it does match the painting. So there we go. That's actually pretty nice. We need to find a good spot for this bear too. I still don't know where to put you. I think we need like more rooms in this house for all of this ridiculous stuff that I have that I have no real place for. Though I would love to buy more furniture from Robin too. So that's something we'll have to think about in the future as well. For now, though, since we have some extra time, why don't we run down to the mines and see if we can get anything out of that little frozen lake that we found? I'm not sure if there's anything special that we can really fish up from there, but I did want to go back and see. It was on floor 60, I believe, and I have a feeling, I mean, we must be getting close to the end of those frozen mines anyway, so maybe there's something good there. Who knows? There might be something good there. It seems like we can kind of collect the things that you can find in the wintertime in the area of the mines, so I'm assuming we'd probably collect winter fish. Oh, there's an owl too. I haven't seen that guy in a while. A little owl flying around in the sky. I guess we don't really do much walking around at nighttime, do we? Walking through the town anymore. We used to come back very late at night all the time when we were going back and forth from the mines. And I'm hoping we can find like a shortcut at some point. Maybe we can use that minecart. I think one of the things that the Junimos were going to fix was the minecart anyways. So maybe that would help us, because it would be really nice if we didn't have to walk all that way to get here. So hopefully we'll get something better than the green algae this time, because that's all we managed to fish up in the last episode, the last time we were here anyway. So let's see, white algae. Well, that's not exactly what I meant. I was hoping for something different. Okay, here's a fish. Here's an actual fish. So hopefully this is going to be something good. Hopefully it's a perfect one. It's another ghost fish. Is that all we can get from the mines? I mean, oh, that's awfully close to the wall. Are we gonna get anything from that? I'm not sure if we're gonna get anything from that. Oh, there we go. A fish who is really, really, really close to the wall and really fast. Oh my goodness, really, really fast, really fast. Do we need like a better rod for this guy? Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness, like, we get really close to capturing him and then he just zips away. Ah, like that. Oh my gosh. Okay, we actually got him, and it was just another ghost fish, and it wasn't even like a really big one or anything. Okay, so I'm starting to think that maybe the ghost fish is all that we can find in here. I mean, you would think there would be something different, but I'm not sure. So far, all of the fish we've gathered from the mines have been ghost fish. Okay, so 3 ghost fish in, guys, and I think that's probably it. I mean, maybe there's something that we can get from those little lakes if we have a better rod. Maybe it's something like that, but I'm not 100% sure. And what about in here? I mean, I know there's different fish that you can get when it's nighttime anyway, so maybe there's something good in here. Let's just test it out. We might as well. I mean, there's one of those chests. Oh gosh, just barely, but I have to get this fish now, otherwise we're gonna lose the chest. So hopefully I can get this. I think we're good now. I think we're safe. I think we're all clear. And that was a chub. But what did we get from the chest? Bait. Oh my gosh, that was it. Oh, that was such a ripoff. That was such a terrible ripoff. Okay, well, we're done fishing for the night, I guess. That was some pretty rotten luck. So we might as well just go back home and we'll sell off the fish. I mean, at least we'll get a little bit of gold right before the winter rolls in. I'm not sure how much fishing we're going to be able to do during the wintertime anyway, because I would imagine that most of the bodies of water are going to be frozen over, so it would be a little bit hard to fish, unless we can, like, cut a little circle in the ice and fish that way. Like, little ice fishing, who knows? There must be something special that we can get during the wintertime. We're going to have to find a different way to make gold, though. We'll still be able to sell our eggs, because we did get a heater for our chickens, so they're going to be quite happy, but we are not going to be able to sell any crops, and that has mainly been, like, my main source of income on the farm so far. So we're going to have to find a different way to do that, and I'm going to sell my white algae, too, because we don't really need that. But we might as well tuck Jess into bed, and I will take a look and see how much that golden pumpkin was worth. So we'll take a look at that too. Let's see. Good night, little Daisy. Oh my goodness, she's curled up by our little bear. That is adorable. So let's see how much that pumpkin was worth. We'll go ahead and go through this screen, which we haven't in a while, and look at that! Oh my gosh, it's actually different! It's all, like, wintry down here now! That is so cool! Whoa, and that's a lot of gold, too! Okay, so the golden pumpkin was worth 2,500 gold! That is awesome! That is really going to give us a boost as the winter just begins! So in the next episode, it is going to be the very first day of winter, and I am so excited to see what that's going to be like, so I hope you guys are too! Thank you guys so much for watching today, and I will see you all next time. Bye!